Good morning, everyone. This is Nikita HB. Today I am here to tell you about the application which requests the permission. So to request the permission for users at the runtime, you need to declare the permissions in Android manifest file. So we have used users permission tag to declare the permission for camera as well as for storage to read and write purpose in the Android manifest file. And we need two buttons, namely storage and camera button. On clicking these two buttons, the permissions should be requested. So we have used storage and camera button in a XML file. And in main activity, at first we have defined the camera and storage buttons, and we have used two codes, namely camera permission code and storage permission code, and we have assigned two values. You can assign any of the values. It is not mandatory to use these values. The main purpose of assigning values is we need to know that if the user clicks camera button or a storage button. For knowing that purpose, we have used the two permission codes, and it should be unique. And we have already declared the permissions in the manifest file. We have here we are setting the buttons using onclick listener, and we have to check the permission. If it has already been granted, then we have to display the toast message saying that permission already granted. If the permission has not been granted, we have to check request the permission again. So we have used the check permission function. In request permission method, we again and again request the permission for the users until he allows. If he keep on denying the permission, and again if we click the storage or camera button, it should ask again and again. It means it should request the permission again and again. So after requesting the permission, we need to know that if he has allowed or denied that particular permission. So we have used on request permission result method, and request code is the one which is used to know that if the user has selected the camera or storage button. So the main purpose of request code is to store whether he clicks camera or storage button, and the permission is if he allows or denies. And if the request code is camera permission code, we have already defined and assigned the value for this camera permission code, and if he clicks the camera button and if he allows the permission, then the toast message should be displayed saying that camera permission granted. If he clicks deny button, then it should display camera permission denied. In the same way, if he clicks storage button and if he allows the permission, then it should display a granted permission granted toast message. If he denies, it should display storage permission denied message. So this is how the application works, and let us run the application. It looks like this. We have two buttons, and if I click storage button, it asks allow permission to access photo and video on your device. And if I click deny option, it displays storage permission denied toast message. And if I again click storage button, again it shows, because in request permission method we have written the function in such a way that it should ask again and again until we allow. Again, if we click deny, again it shows the message, and again if we click, it keep on asking the permission until I allow. Now I'll click the allow button. You can see storage permission granted toast message. And now if I click again the storage button, it displays already granted. It again displays already granted message. And in the same way, the camera, if I go to camera and if I again click the deny button, again it shows. And once if I click deny and don't ask message, and again if I click camera button, it again does not show because I have click deny and don't ask message. So this is a simple application which shows which is used for requesting the permission to use the features of Medium. So thank you for listening. Thank you.